we're going to start off today reviewing what we talked about 2 weeks ago. We talked about who created Braille. Noah?
Louis Braille.
Okay. Why did he create Braille?
Because he was blind.
Well, he went to school, and what was he not able to do that everyone else could?
Read or something?
He couldn't read. There was no way for him to be able to do it.
Yeah.
Do you remember what happened when he was about 12 years old, who he met?
Not really.
Anybody else remember who he met? He met Charles Barbier, who was a French military officer who had created a system called sonography so that soldiers could communicate with each other at night in the dark. His system was based on 12 dots. But no, what was wrong with his system?
He was only a 6.
Well, no, what was wrong with Barbier's system that people couldn't use it?
Not really good with this stuff. But
it was too large for the human finger to be able to interpret.
That's what I
so
back
what did Braille do?
It allowed you to read with your fingers without using your eyes.
He came up with a system based on how many dots?
6.
6. Here, you want to show me? Now, one of the problems Braille discovered with his system of Braille was that it took up so much space. Just to give you an example, this is a print copy of Julius Caesar that you just read. This is Noah's copy. Notice how much larger it is? Now, what Braille did was he came up with a system of contractions to be used so that Braille would take up less space. Now, his system of contractions is different than what we're used to. For us, a contraction would be, instead of do not, we'd say don't. But what Braille did was he came up with a system, and there's a worksheet in your folder that shows them.
If you have an S's around here, you can pass that around too.
He came up with a system of contractions for commonly used words or letter combinations so that the Braille would take up less space. To practice a little bit, okay? The first station, you can check out some Braille books, and keep in mind when you look at those books, most of them are geared towards young children. Some of them, in addition to having Braille in them, have things inside them that kids would be able to feel that would help them interact with the story. Most of the books that are up there also have the print in them so that teachers, parents, siblings can read the story along with the child. The second station is tactile discrimination. You are going to identify the Braille cell that is different and then the ones that match. Station 3, there are some activities in your packet using Braille that you guys are going to work on. And the last one is station 4. There are Braille riddles that you are going to decode.
Oh, it's different. Okay? So, right now you're in the market. Carl knows how to do this.
Wow. This is hard.
Very hard. We did it last week.
Yeah, he's not that talented.
I'm thinking this one right
now. Okay, so circle it for him. Help him out.
Circle down.
Yeah, it's hard to do both at the same time.
Am I right or wrong?
You guys let me see. You are correct.
All right. So, I have to close my eyes. Somebody help me with my finger.
Not only are there those things to remember, there's indicators. Oh, she can help.
The idea, that's a real coloring book.
She likes that.
And the idea is the kids can practice using these phone circles, making the different letters.
Is this the way you read it down, or do you go across?
There you go.
So I might read a book, but I still go across.
Yes. Hey. You're right.
Hey, and the other thing too is that he didn't really go over. You guys are filling by finger.
Really?
You're actually supposed to.
You would use both hands.
You have to use both hands.
No way.
And ideally,
both hands track across. The right one stays. The left one finds the next
one. No way.
And then the other one comes back.
No, it's just it's correct.
Punctuation. It is.
I'm using my eyes. This one, there's no match.
So that one's
correct.
No match.
Yeah, okay. Yes.
And this one is correct.
Oh, so the raised ones.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense.
The raised ones are the
I'm with you, though. So I gotta make sure this is, so then I gotta put down all the other ones.
Yep.
Okay.
Remember the same thing?
Oh, I was right. We're gonna have to stay, we'll save the riddles for later, because we're gonna have some time for snacks and coffee and mingling.
That's an ING, not letter.
You showed them the different books?
Yeah, no, I did not yet. This is a style.
It's just a little gadget that you can make some letters on. We're gonna save Brian's kind of time. You came out with a real...
So if I push these up, and then you'd want to...
You can make letters, yeah. Yeah.
It's like, there's no dot, dot, dot in here.
These ones are easier, because you can do these ones with your eyes.
What?
What is this?
15.
This letter, what does that mean?
Which one?
Where's my red line?
Who's here, that's number one. That's number one. That's a period, Carl. Do you want me to really, it says what? Right here, wait, W-A-G-T, what?
First one done gets prize.
Come on, Carl, you can do this, buddy.
You can use your Braille alphabet.
What'd you call?
For the end, maybe.
Hey, Carl, there's business cards working back here.
Get to work.
What do you call a bear with no teeth?
It's called...
No, let him figure it out.
A gummy bear.
I got a ball.
So you didn't really trick us with any capital letters or anything?
I don't think so.
All right, he goes, give us first, you guys do. Okay, we have what? Let's start. Skateboard, then what's the next one? Earthquake.
Earthquake.
Earthquake, then what?
Football.
Football, then... Then...
Watermelon.
I'm helping.
Then...
Rattlesnake.
Then...
Taylor.
Ashdown.
All right. When we're writing sentences for vocabulary, he uses this Braille writing.
And you have to see what it guess what it says.
This one, you are going to find...
Are you gonna figure out what it says?
Okay, this is a B right here, right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. That's the only
There's
letter
one contraction
do.
In there. It's ST.
Oh, jeez. All right.
What is that?
Yeah.
Did you use a contraction?
No.
Okay.
Bet you it's best.
Yeah, it is.
My man. See, I didn't understand.
Person.
Yeah, you're the man. You're the man.